Hello everyone, I welcome to you to this session of webinar, and the topic for today's webinar is Report Mastery in Business Central Building Brilliance. And I'm your trainer, my name is Vijay JB. Before starting the session, let me give a short introduction about myself. I am Vijay JB, I'm working as a corporate trainer with Koenig Solutions, and I have good experience in training about Business Central technicals and also have trained on Microsoft Navision 2018. I've been delivering trainings in technical side of Business Central. And also have trained on data structure and algorithms. I've taken numerous sessions on C, C++, Java, Python, HTML, and various other technologies. So with that experience, I'm here to take today's webinar, which is based on reports in Business Central. And now let's understand the today's agenda. So today we'll start with understanding the reports first. The overview of reports. Then we'll see about report description, how a report is, how it is described, and then we'll see the report layouts. So we have three different layouts in reports. So we'll understand all of the three layouts first, and then we'll have an exercise where we'll create the reports by using a word report, like using a word layout, and also if the time permits, we'll also see even RDLC layout as well. And then once we are done with all the things, we'll summarize at the end. And at last, we'll have a Q&A session where we'll be open to take up any questions related to the course or related to today's session. So make sure you note down all your questions and post in the chat window. So let's begin. Before starting with the actual reports, let us understand what is Business Central. As many majority of you might already be knowing, but let me give a quick introduction, like what is Business Central? This is an ERP system. As you know, ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. So this is a complete end-to-end business solution for any small to medium-sized businesses. They use the software, to connect and manage all the processes. You have different data in your company, like finance, sales, purchasing, etc., inventory. So all this data, you're connecting and managing that in a business center under one hood. So that makes the process easier and simpler. And what is the target audience for this webinar? That is also very important. So the target audience, this is basically for developers, all the Business Central developers who are already been working in either Business Central development or even the Navision developers as well, those who want to upgrade to Business Central. So the basic knowledge is must. You should be having some basic knowledge of Business Central, how it works, and some basic knowledge of even the development side as well, how you are publishing your project. And you should be knowing about configuration files, what is launch.json, application app.json. So these are things, few things you should be knowing so that you can understand today's webinar. But even then, I will try to cover in a very basic way so that even a newcomer can able to understand. But yeah, the people who are already worked in Business Central, like development side, would be more clear about this today's webinar. Now let us start at the actual content. So we'll understand what is report. Reports are basically, it is used to print or display information from Business Central database. So in the database, we'll have all our data. Let's say we have customer data, item data. So we get this information from the database and we create some reports, like to make some meaningful reports. Like for example, we summarize information and print documents such as sales quote, invoices, purchase quote, purchase invoice. So all these documents we created, how we create, we retrieve information from the database and we summarize them and make reports. And also reports are not only used to display, sometimes it can also be used to process data without printing information. For example, if we want to update the item list in our item table and such other processes, if we want to work on them, even that's also possible. So this is how reports can be used. And how this report description looks like. So this is a brief of report description. Later, after a few minutes, we'll go to the Visual Studio Code and we'll start coding, and then you'll be more clear with all the description. For now, we'll understand how the report is as an object. So in the report, we have the report properties. Like for every object in Business Central, they have their own properties, which describes that object. So in this case, a report is one object. So they have their own properties. And then the reports have triggers, triggers in basic, you might be knowing about triggers. These triggers are used to perform some action after an event occurs. Yes, so these are called as triggers. and we have data items. Data items are nothing but, these are nothing but tables. Tables, we call it as data items, where we get the actual data from. So these data items, again, have their own properties. They have their triggers and columns, or what you call as columns in general of the tables. These are columns, and columns also have their own properties. Okay, and we have labels, and labels have their own properties. Next up, we have request page for a report. So what does a request page will do? They also have their own properties, triggers, and control. So these are helpful, you know, for setting up filters. Let's say we want to get a report. We don't want to get all of the data. Let's say we are taking data from customer table, but we want to set some filters. Maybe we want a report only of customers who have purchased so-and-so products, or customers whose balance is like greater than 5,000, etc. So we can set some filters. So that filters will appear on the request page. So this is how we can use request page. And we have also the RDLC data. Okay. So this is just a description of the report. Going forward, we'll understand in while coding, we'll understand one by one again. And make sure that if you have any doubts in meanwhile of the session also, please post it in the chat so that you don't miss out any of your doubts. At the end of the session, all your doubts will be clear before we wind up. So make sure you note down your doubts. And now about report layouts. So what is this report layout? It is the visual layout that determines the content and format of the report when it's viewed or printed. So now in the previous slide, we saw that we get the data from database, like for example, customer table. But report is the layout where we decide how our report should look like. Let's suppose we want to display it in the paragraph format, or we want either a table to be displayed, so etc. How you want your report, so that you will decide in via the layouts. So these are the three layouts supported. One is Word report layout, one is RDLC report layout, and another one is Excel report layout. And this Excel report is been added recently in the Business Central. In previous versions, there was not support of Excel layout, maybe before 2020. So that time we had Word and RDLC. Then later versions, in the recent version, they have added Excel report layout as well. That will make things easier. Okay, so now it's about exercise. Now this webinar is all about exercise. So I'll open Visual Studio Code now, and we'll create the report from scratch, from all the properties, and we'll publish that report and see the changes. Well, let me open Visual Studio Code. So here is my project ready. So this is a basic project. I've just not created any files now. So let's start. First, I'll make a new folder so that we can work on that. I'll name this as, let's say, reports. And in the reports, I'll create a new file to create a new report for reports. Okay. So I'll name this as, let's say, first I'll create a Word layout. So I'll name it as Word layout report.layout. So we have, as you know, as you have already developed maybe, so you know that we have snippets in Business Central, you know, to get the like an outline of the code for every object. So to access the snippets, we just press T in front of any object name, then we'll get snippet of that particular object. In this case, we are creating a report. So to get the report snippet, we just press T and report keyword. See, just if we click on that, we will get a snippet of the report. Likewise for any other objects. For example, if we were creating some table, so we just press T in front of the table keyword, then we get the snippet of the table. Likewise, so for any object, if we are creating, let's say, a page, so we press T page and we will get the snippet of the page. So this is a good feature of snippets, of using snippets, so that will save us time rather than writing everything from scratch. We can make use of these snippets. So again, I'm creating a report, right? So I'm using T report, the snippet for the report. So this is my report layout. Now we'll start writing everything from scratch. Okay, so first thing, as of now, I'll remove few properties we're not using as of now. So first we'll begin with very basics. Here we are giving the report ID and the name of the report. So IDs should always be unique. Make sure that your multiple reports are not having the same IDs. They should be unique. So I'm giving the report starting from ID number 50110. And my report name I'll give as, let's say, customer report. Okay. And what are ID ranges? Let me remind you, you'll be knowing your ID ranges in the app.json. So whatever is the ID ranges, so this is ranging from 50,100 to 50,149. So that should be within that range, right? So here is now here are some basic properties that you should remember, that you should give it. For example, we have this application area is equal to all, and this usage category is equal to report and analysis. This one we are giving for the searching purposes. We have some other options as well here. We have documents, history, list, and administration. So accordingly, which one is your category, you have to give it. So later when I publish, I'll show you how it is this are helpful. Okay. Now, let us define the data item, which is most important in a report, meaning where we are getting the data from. So here I'll take, as I said already mentioned, we'll take the customer table. So I just type the customer, and the IntelliSense feature of Visual Studio Code will suggest the table names. So here we can see that we are highlighted that customer table. So I click on customer. Right. So there are two parameters here. One is the customer table actual name, and here is the user defined name. So this one is optional. You can give either same, or you can give any other name, or you can give customer tab or whatever you want. So better to give the same name to avoid any confusion. And here are the column sections, meaning what fields you want in a data set. From the customer table, if you just hover on that, you will see what are the fields available. We have number, name, search name, name to address. So let me retrieve few fields so that I can display in my report. I will take the basic one, that is number first. Okay, just click on the number. And likewise, I'll add other columns as well. I'll take the basic name also. And let me take one more column, that is balance. I'll take balance also. These are the three fields I have retrieved as of now. And I'll comment the other part, which we are not using as of now. Yes, so we are ready with our basic report. So where we have retrieved what from the customer table, one is customer number, one is name, one is balance. And now is that we have to define the layout, what layout we are using. As I mentioned, there are three layouts, right? One is Word and RDLC and Excel. So we'll start with the Word now. So we have this property called as default layout, and this one we have to, if you just press control and space, wherever you press control and space, it will give you the suggestions. It is the IntelliSense feature of Visual Studio Code. So here, if you want to know what are the available options, you can just press control and space. You will get the three options. One is Excel, RDLC, and Word. So we are starting with the Word layout. You're done defining that, you are using Word layout now. And you have to give the name also, like the file name as well. So we have that property, that is Word layout, and here I have to give the name of the file. So I'll tell that this is a customer report dot, and what is the extension for any document file, that is docx, right? So this two properties will make sure that our layout is what, Word layout. And once you are done defining, so this is a basic report ready. We are ready to build a project now. So once we build a project, we make the package, then this Word file will be generated, and then we can go and design there, right? So how to build that, how to package. So you go in file options, in the view we have command palette to give all of the commands. So again, let me tell you, in the options, in the view, here in the command palette, so if you click on command palette, here you can write all of your AL commands. So I'm giving this command package. So just click on package, you see that it says that the package is created. And And also parallel, you can see that there is customer report.docx document file is being created. So now is the time to go to this Word layout and design our report. We'll design how our report will look like, whether it is having a table or anything, designing part. So let me open it via the externally, because Microsoft Word is an external source, right? It's external software. So we have to open externally, that is via Word to design it. So I will open externally, which will open up through the Microsoft Word now. So now you might wonder, where are these data sets? How I should design it? Where I'll get all this customer, what we took it, right? Customer number, name, and balance, where they will appear. So we have this developer option, as you can see here in the ribbon. So this developer option will not be enabled by default. Like, we have to enable it for the first time. So how to enable it is, so you go in file here and go to options, and here you will be having customized ribbon option. Let me tell you again. So you go in file and you go in options, and here is the customized ribbon. So you click on customized ribbon, So by default, it will be unselected developer option. So for the first time, you have to select it and click OK. Once you're done with that, so your developer option will be enabled. This will be visible in your ribbon. Now, where to go now? Next step is XML mapping pane. You click here, and here in your drop-down menu, customize in this. In the side, if you drop down and you see here that our data set is ready. See reports and customer report, the object ID that we gave, 50110. If I click on this and you see here our data set is ready with the number, name and balance. These are the three fields, right? We have retrieved from customer table. So data set is ready. Now let us create a design, like a layout for our customer report. So better I'll include a table, where in the table I will list number, name and balance to make it visible in a meaningful way. So I'll insert a table. I'll include three rows. We have three rows here. So my first, three columns, my bad. So my first column will be number, and then the first number, and second one is what? Customer name, and third one is what? And then you take balance also. Okay, so we have three fields ready. Now is the time to map it. Just we have defined the name, customer number, name and balance. Now we have to parallelly map that. First field is number, second field is name, and third is balance. So how to map that? We click on whichever the column we want. First one we call it, we want to map the number, customer number. So click on that field and click on this number here and right click. And here is the option insert content control. So we have different options according to the type of field. If it's a picture, then we have to select picture. If it's a checkbox, combo box, etc. Likewise, this is a plain text. So I am entering a plain text. Similarly, we will map now customer name also. Click on customer name. And again, go to name here, insert content control and plain text. Similarly, I'll do it for balance as well. So balance, click on balance, insert content control and as a plain text. So now we have mapped it, all of the three fields, as you can see, number, name and balance. So we have mapped all of the three columns. So we can simply save now and close it. So I'm going here, the option save and close this. And now we'll publish our report and we'll see that whether it is working or not as we expected. So in the launch.json, how to publish this report? So here in the launch.json, we'll go and we have this two properties, right? Startup object ID and startup object type. So as soon as I publish my project, I want to see what. So here are four options we have. One is page, query and report and table. So I'm selecting a report here because we want a report, right? As soon as the launch. So startup object type means as soon as we publish what we want as starting, like as soon as we publish. So I want a report as soon as I publish. And which report, that is the ID I have to give it here. ID is what? It is 50110. The same thing I'm giving here, 50110. And how to publish again, you have to go in view command palette and we can publish here. We have two options. One is publish without debugging and publish with debugging. So as of now, we are not learned debugging. So I will publish without debugging. So click on without publish without debugging. Yes, so here it is publishing now. We should be getting what first? We'll get the request page. I'll show you what request page is. So this is the request page where we'll be having all of the options. As I said, you'll be having filters and you'll be having the what kind of report layout it is. It is what in a document format, right? And we have down here buttons. One is to send to anyone or whether to print a report or before printing, if you want to preview and see how your report will look like, you have that option. And we have one is cancel option. So first we'll see preview and close. First we'll see preview so that we can understand how our report is, what are the data we are getting from that. I'll click on preview and this will be taking some time to render and depends on the data. So we have, see, currently we have retrieved one record from the customer table. But as you know here, only there is one record showing up. But in the customer, we have many multiple records. But why is that here it's showing only one record, okay? So that is the designing part. In the word layout, we have to give one more step so that we'll get all of the records. As of now, it is only showing one record, right? So let us do that also. So what is that we have to do? I'll tell you. We'll go back to again that word file. Yes. I'll open this Word file again and we have to add one more property so that we'll retrieve all of the records. Because currently you saw it is only retrieving first record. So again, I'll open that developer option and XML mapping pane. This is the data set, right? Customer. What we have to do, we have to select all of these three fields. Click on the first column, that is number, and select all the three like this. Drag and drop. Okay, when you select these three, and you have to add one property here, that is, see here, right click on customer and insert content control, add repeating. So when you add repeating, then it will repeat all of the records instead of just showing up the first record. So this is a very important step. Okay, let me recall how to do it again. So you have to click on the first column number and drag here and select all the three fields. When you select all the three fields or columns, now again, go on the customer, the main data set, the table name, click on the insert content control and add repeating. See, as soon as you add repeating, there is one more icon also, which shows that you have added successfully. Now they will be repeating. So now you will retrieve all of the records here in your customer table. And save this and close again. Click save. And now let us publish the project again. I will go in my view command palette. And this is the option, publish without debugging. Yes. Now let us preview and see. Now previously we saw only one record, right? This time it should be repeating all of the records which are there in customer. So I do preview and close. Yes. As you can see now, all of the there are totally five records in customer, starting from customer number 10,000, 20, 30, 40, and 50, with all the balances also. So this is how you retrieve all of the records in the customer. In this demo data, we have only five records. But in your real-time cases, there will be huge data. So it will come in multiple pages. So it will be retrieving all of the records from that table, which you mentioned, that is customer. I hope you understood. Any doubts, please again, put it in the chat window so that your doubts will be clear in the Q&A session. I hope you're clear about this. Now, let us go back to Visual Studio Code. And now, as I was telling you about the filters also, as I told you, we can set filters on the request page. How to do that? So we have this property called as request filter fields, where we have to mention which fields we want it as a filters. So it's like, it's not only limited to one or two fields. We can keep as many fields as we want on the request filter fields. So now, for example, I will select one is number, one is name. So, and also likewise, you can select as many fields you want. So currently I have selected two filter fields. So next time now, when you publish in your request page, you'll be getting these two fields as a filters. So you can set the filter and accordingly and get the report of your filter, like the one you, how you filter them. So let me publish and show you. Again, I will go in view and command palette, publish without debugging. Yes, now it's publishing. So as you can see here, there are two filters. If you saw the code, we have given number and name as the filters, right? So accordingly, now it will fetch the only data that we want. For example, we want, as you can see, number is a drop down. So we can select, we wanted only the record of 2000. So I click on 2000th record and do preview. If you see, it will be only showing this particular record, right? So this is how you set the filters. As of now, currently there is one record, so it is showing only one record. But in such cases, like if you select, you set a filter field as balance and maybe you wanted all the records so having greater than balance 10,000, etc. So in such cases, it will make more sense. So it is up to you how you want to use the request filter fields. Right? So this is about the request adding filters on the request page. I hope you're clear about that. And now let us see one more. I was also mentioning that we have even the RDLC layout and also the Excel layout. So Excel is very easy. And for the Excel, we don't need to design anything new. Report, we are just mentioning Excel layout, like how we do for the Word. And also we'll just mention the Excel layout name and your Excel layout will be ready. We don't open that with externally and design it. Okay, just let me show you one example. We'll create one new file here for the Excel layout.pl. So here simply, instead of creating new one, I'll copy the same code and we'll just change some properties, just the Word default layout. And first thing, obviously, we have to make sure that all our IDs are unique. So I'm giving it what 50111. And this one, I'll give customer report Excel, since we are creating Excel, right? And some other properties. Yes, the main important, we have to change default layout to Word. This time we want Excel. So I'm creating Excel now. And this property, instead of Word layout, it should be what? It should be Excel layout. We have to give a name for Excel layout, right? So again, I'm giving customer Excel report, just a name. And what should be the extension for any Excel file, which is XLSX, right? So this is the extension. Make sure you give your correct extension. These are the two properties I've changed. The rest everything is same, I have kept it. So now we directly publish this report and see our Excel layout report will be ready. We can directly download in Excel format. So that is also very easy. Okay. So I'll go in my launch.json. I will launch this report now. Okay. Where is launch.json? Here it is. And I will give ID at this time 50111. And go to command palette. You have shortcut for command palette also. That is Control Shift P. So that will directly launch your command palette. And here I give the command that is publish without debugging. So we have our request page here. That is which report we are currently taking. That is customer report, right? And as you can see here, for the Excel layout, we don't have preview option. We can directly download a file that will be Excel file. So just click on download and see your report is downloaded with the same name, that is customer report Excel. I click on this and show you the data. It will be all of those five records that are there currently in our customer table. See, 1,000, 20,000, all of the records. And it is up to you now if you want to modify the data, like want to make it appear better. Yes. So this is about the Excel one, and it's more easier to create Excel reports as we are not externally opening it and designing it. We are just defining that this is the Excel layout and your report will be generated. So this is about Word and Excel layout. And now is the third layout, that is RDLC. Now let me tell you about RDLC also. We'll create one new file and there we'll see how to create RDLC. And this has RDLC report.al. And so like same code, I will paste it again and we'll change the ID. So it's to save time, we have to understand the concept, right? So 50112, the new ID I gave it. And this one, I name it as customer. Which one? This is the RDLC. Okay. So, and these two properties, what I have to change? Default layout will be what this time? This will be RDLC. And the word layout will be what? Instead of that, we are using RDLC, right? RDLC layout. And name your layout file name also. Give it as customer RDLC report. And what is the extension? It will be .RDLC. Simple as that. And now for the RDLC, to design it, we need a Microsoft report builder. How for the word layout, we are having Microsoft Word to design it. For the Excel, we have MS Excel. Likewise, for the RDLC layout, we have Microsoft Report Builder. That is, we can download from the internet. That is a free software. Let me show you how to download here. In the Google, I'll show you that as Microsoft Report Builder. So this is the software. This is just a normal and small software you can download. Just normal installation. Just click on like next, general instructions. And once you're done installing, that's all. We don't need to sign or any different option. Just download and install it. Your basic installation. And once you're done downloading, now let us see how to design it via the RDLC layout. So we are done with our code. We didn't manipulate anything. So it is all same. We are not adding any filters as of now. The rest everything is same. The default layout is RDLC. Now let us build a project. We'll make the package. So here in the command palette, what is the command here? AL package. So as soon as you click on package, how it created Word and Excel, right? So there will be one .RDLC file. And there we have to open that RDLC externally via what? Via the report builder. And there we have to design it, like how we design Word layout. Similarly, we'll design that also. So I'll do package. See, as I click package, created a file that is of .RDLC layout. Sorry, RDLC extension. Click on that and open it externally. As soon as you click open externally, it will automatically open via the Microsoft report builder. Let me show you that it is here. And for the default, if it did not open via that, it will ask you for an option, like to choose a software to open it. So in that case, you choose Microsoft Report Builder. Okay. So now is the time to design. So this again, Microsoft Report Builder is a software to create reports, not just reports of Business Central. It is also used by many other software, other applications. This is commonly used to create reports. So you can learn more detail about this. But just let me give a quick example and how we created a word. Similarly, we'll quickly create one table and we'll add a fields and we'll generate a report. Okay. The first basic properties, we can set it whether we want a report in in a landscape mode or in a portrait mode. So there is more flexibility in Report Builder. As it is made for the report, so it has more flexibility. It is more easier to create than word layout. Okay. So we'll add first basic property. See, we have here add page header, page footer, that we can do it. So I'm adding report properties here. First, I'll select whether I want my report in a landscape mode or portrait mode. I'll select landscape mode, and you can select the width, height, everything, margins. So it is more flexible here. As of now, I'll just select in a landscape mode. Okay. Now, how we'll do, like, we'll add even the page header, footer, everything we can do it. So your page footer is there. See, we can add, for example, in the page header, the company logo or anything related to company like that. And with the main content, we'll add it here. So let me add a table and show you. Here it'll go in insert and add table. So it is like a easier to do it here. So if you add, want to add more for columns and all, so just wow. Go and insert column and add right and left. You have to select this option, anyone. As of now, we have only three fields, right? So I'm not adding anyone. So we have number, name, and balance. So, and also it's more simpler here. We are just dragging and dropping here. See, number, I'm dragging and dropping here. Name, I'm dragging and dropping here. And balance also, I'm dropping. And this is not a field here. This is automatically generated for all the calculated fields. Balance is a calculated field. So this comes along with that. But these are the main three fields, that is number, name, and balance. So we are simply dragging and dropping. Like, not unlike in Word, we have to map it manually, and also we have to set the content control to repeating. So here we don't need to do that. Here all of the records will repeat. So we don't need to add extra property that is repeating. We'll get all of the customer records now. So let us see that. I will go on file and click on save. Yes. Let us add some more information. Like here, we'll add a company name also. I'll go in insert, and let's say, example, I'm adding a text box here. Let us increase the size of this before adding. This is okay. Then now we'll add the international, let's say, company name here. And I'll make that center. Okay. So just I've added a text box. Likewise, we have some built-in fields also here. If you see here, click on built-in fields, you have here many built-in, like we have page number, page name, like user ID, etc. So here I can just drag and drop and place them where I want to do. For example, I add here user ID in the header section. And also, let's say I want to add page number in the footer. So I will add your page number. We have this page number, right? So just drag and drop the page number. Yeah. So these are all automated fields present for every by default, it will come for all the reports. Yes. So I will save this now. Here we have the icon to save here and save and close this report. Now we'll go back and publish our RDLC report. What is the ID? That is 112-50112. Let's select from here 50112. And we go to command palette and publish without debugging. Yes, so it is publishing now. Let us wait. Yes. So here it says that it is RDLC now. So I'll preview and close. So you'll be able to see all of the records. See that is open in what? In the landscape view, right? It is not portrait. See, this is a user ID it has taken. Currently, I have logged in according that user ID it has taken, and the company name and the records here. So all of the records. So and the page number also. It is page number 1, page number 2, 3. So likewise, accordingly, what width and size you can select it accordingly. So that is all flexible in Microsoft Report Builder. So you can select all the width of the field, etc. So to make it appear small. So we have just kept it default as of now. I hope you got the idea of creating all of the reports, that is all the layouts, that is Word, Excel, and RDLC. We have just taken all the examples and understood that. Hope this is clear. Now let us move back to PPT. We are done creating all the exercise as well. Now let us summarize what we have learned today. So first we have saw about the report overviews. Why are these report overviews? Why this report is generally used to create some meaningful information or reports like sales invoice, sales documents, or like example, we are taking customer information or like customer sales by quantity, or we are taking top 10 customers. In such examples where we are summarizing some data, we are using this report. Yes, and next we saw what report description, what the report has. You saw the report properties, we saw request page section, and we saw various data items, etc. Right. And next we saw about report layouts. we understood all the three layouts, that is Excel, Word, and RDLC. And in the exercise part, we took all the three examples and created all of the reports. We saw how we can set filters, etc. So it is pretty much clear, right? And now let me tell you about this course also. Like, you can get in touch with our representatives at our original website, that is www.koenigsolution.com. So let me head over to this let me show you how to access our website. So there is an official website, that is www.koenigsolutions.com, where you can, if you want to learn more about this course, you can just go in the search window and select MBA20, type MBA20 here. So you'll get the course details more here. Okay, 1 second. Or type the Business Central better, you'll get all the suggestions here. So, and search here Business Central. So you have different courses here. So this is the one that is main developer, Business Central developer. And also you can look out the other courses as well. So this is officially launched by Microsoft, MBA 20. And from here, you can download the official course content as well. So you will have an idea what entirely discovered in the course. Okay. And what are the other things we offer? We offer one-on-one advantage sessions, and we have 4-hour sessions, 8-hour sessions. We are flexible to everything. We have destination training option, and also we have Flexi, that is on-demand videos. So these are the wide variety of things that we offer at Koenig. So make sure if you want to enroll for this course, get in touch with our representatives. And now is a set time for Q&A. So please feel free to post your questions in the Q&A window. We will be available to answer all of your questions. Yes, we have got the first question. So here's the question: Are we get training or trained on Microsoft Dynamics latest version? Yes, we are going to get trained on the Microsoft latest version, because we are using the cloud version for the MBA 20. That is the latest version. Yes.
Hi Vijay, sorry to interrupt you for a second. Small announcement from my side. Hi everyone, if anybody wants to continue for the course or wants to continue for the enrollment of the training, I have shared my details in the chat. Kindly mail me the details along with your country and your contact details so that our expert can get back to you with the relevant and accurate details. And kindly fill the attendance sheet as well for the webinar certificates. And do follow us on LinkedIn for the further webinars as well. Thank you, Vijay. Over to you again.
Yeah, thank you, Nicholas. Feel free to ask any questions. Please post in the Q&A. Nicholas, I guess there is a question for you. Or just want to check that.
I just saw the message. You can drop me your details on my email, or if the course will be there, we can customize as well. Kindly share me the details so that our expert will get back to you. You can share me the details first.